Hey everybody, welcome to Binge Bar. Did you know that during the 2018 Stanley Cup Finals, Baltimore TV had the third highest ratings in terms of viewers? Of course behind Vegas and Washington, but surprisingly, not by much. Baltimore is a hockey town, so where's their team? Today, that's what we're going to talk about. Hockey in Baltimore. Baltimore actually used to have a team. Of course they were an AHL team, but probably the most successful one. They were called the Clippers, and at times they would outsell the NBA's Baltimore Bullets. The Clippers only lasted about 15 years, but the people of Baltimore were thrilled when they were informed of the 1967 NHL expansion. Baltimore was promised a team, and it was almost 100% guaranteed it was going to happen. So what happened next? The biggest key to why Baltimore didn't succeed in the 1967 draft was due to one thing. They didn't have an arena. Well, they did have one, but it was pretty awful. It was a rectangle and all seats faced forward. There was a limited view of the ice and overall it would just lead to a very unpleasant experience at hockey games. Instead, Los Angeles, Pittsburgh, Oakland, Minnesota, and Philadelphia were awarded NHL franchises. But the dream for hockey in Baltimore didn't end there though. The 1970s were a roller coaster of emotions for the desperate fans of hockey in Baltimore. It started with the Bullets owner at the time seeing the success of the AHL team. He built an arena in Landover, Maryland to home the team who formerly played in Baltimore. The 1974 expansion draft arrived, and Kansas City and Washington, D.C. were actually given NHL franchises. The Washington Capitals would home this new arena alongside the Bullets, who today are known as the Washington Wizards. But even with all this occurring, the 1970s and the very early 80s, Baltimore was actually considered for relocation of the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Oakland Seals. But due to the Washington Capitals housing the only suitable arena anywhere to be found, plans fell through rather quickly. Baltimore would continue to get AHL affiliates almost as often as they would lose them. It's a pretty big problem when a minor team won't even play in your only arena, but even today, hockey in Baltimore is still very, very possible. Realistically though, only one thing has to happen for Baltimore to succeed in the hockey market. They have to build an arena that's perfect for entertainment and sporting events. If that one thing happens, I would bet my life on them getting a franchise no sooner than tomorrow. The NHL is constantly expanding, and with that being said, there are already teams in the league that are looking to move. Now there is a hockey market with a brand new arena. It wouldn't shock me if Ottawa, Sunrise, or Arizona hopped on the train there overnight. Unlike Arizona or even Carolina for that fact, Baltimore has that passion and that drive for the sport that you don't see in those states. The hockey market is so present in Baltimore, and the only thing that's standing in their way is the same thing that's standing in their way about 50 years ago. They need the arena. And once they get that arena, which I really think is going to happen one day, if it's not an expansion team, a team's going to relocate there, and the chances of that happening to me are very, very high. Of course, though, with the Washington Capitals being under 50 miles away, if they were to get a team, they would have to pay some kind of compensation fee due to territorial rights. Personally, if you ask me, there is no other city in the United States, maybe other than Houston, that deserves a team more than Baltimore. They have been waiting a very long time, and I think it's about time that the wheels start turning. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more content. Thank you. We'll see you next time.